Hi everyone, it's Stacy from peonylanedesigns.com. Have you subscribed to the channel yet? If not, click the link below. I'm going to show you how to layer paint to get a distressed look.
Don't forget to click the subscribe button, comment down below, like this video, and click the bell icon to be notified.
If you're new to the channel, thanks for subscribing. If you've been here forever, one of the OGs, one of the originals, thanks for being here again. So today I'm going to talk about layering paint to get a distressed look. So if you want sort of a vintage feel or a vintage vibe and more of a distressed piece on your furniture, and you don't want the same old, just slap a coat of white on it and sand it down. You want more of an authentic, it's been around, painted 100 times. How do we do that? So I'm going to show you how we're going to do that, and I'm going to do it on this. This is somebody else's mom's craft project. I don't know who painted this before. I got it at a thrift store, and you can see whoever painted it before had they must have spray painted it, because there's just drips all over this project. They did not paint the bottom. This irritates me to no end. Let's just go the whole hog and paint the whole thing, guys. And it's just not pretty. I mean, the color's dated. This is clearly a 1990s when everything was Kelly green and burgundy. This is the burgundy that everybody had everything painted. And this would be something that you'd have you can use it as a little caddy for your tools. You could use it for your gardening tools. You could put it on your table and put your remote controls in it so we can find those darn things, I swear. You can put flowers in it and put it on your table. You could put your silverware on it on a buffet with some jars in there. You could do a lot with a little tote like this. And usually I would paint it white for resale, but I'm getting tired of painting white. So I thought what I would do is give it a really fun vintagey feel by giving it more of a distressed look. With smaller pieces like this, I can kind of get away with that in the shop. Obviously furniture stays really, really neutral, but with something like this, you can kind of have some fun. And I'm gonna show you 4 different ways actually to get that distressed look when we layer these paints. One of them is a wax distressing. One of them is a crackle finish. One of them is to sand it. And one of them is to water distress. Now, all of those techniques can be used with all kinds of paint. Like, you can use a latex paint. The last one, the water distressing, that's just primarily with chalk and clay based paints. We'll go over all this later. But I picked my colors, and wait till you see them. So I decided that I'm going to use Annie Sloan's English Yellow underneath Junk Gypsy Bungalow 47's Wanderlust. So it's going to be these 3 colors. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is the wax distressing, and I always keep unscented white candle. They're unscented white candles for a reason, and the reason being is I use these to wax door slides. So if you have a door on a project that's sticking just a little bit and you rub a little wax on it, and I will do that actually on a project I have over here, it keeps it from rubbing. So it just kind of glides, you know, across the wax. And it's wonderful for sticky drawers that way. It's just a nice little trick, but it's also great for distressing. Now, wax distressing actually gets you the furthest down into the layers of paint. So where I wanna see the red pop out, where I wanna see this color pop out, I'm gonna hit it with wax. So I know for sure the most wear would be underneath the handle. So I'm gonna hit this with a good thick coat of wax. And I've showed wax distressing techniques before. You can do this with spray paint. You can do this with any kind of paint. It's fantastic. So I'm gonna just rub See, you can see I've got a really thick coat of paint, and then see where I've got the smears? You're gonna get, that's where the flaking is gonna come away. So in some places in that smear, it's not completely coated with wax. The paint's gonna stick there and it's gonna give you a more natural, distressed look. So where the heavy wear is, I will hit this on the edges where I wanna see color. You can even hit it sort of in here. Try and remember where you hit the wax. And that's usually why I hit it on the edges, because when you're done, you're going to take something like this palette knife and you're gonna scrape that wax away. So you will get all the way down to the red. Now, the reason I'm not sanding these drips away is because with a layered paint look, after years and years of painting and painting and painting, you're gonna get a buildup of paint. So that's actually gonna help us have a more natural look to the distressed layered paint look. So I'm not too concerned about that. If you are, you certainly could have just sanded those away. But I'm gonna get to waxing. Okay, now I have my wax done all the way around my project. And you can kind of see it's heavy in some places, really light in other places. My advice for that is try to be intentionally random. Does that make sense? So on a natural piece of wear where flaking would happen, it wouldn't happen in a uniformed way. So you want to make sure that your placement of your wax is random. Okay? And this will be what you do before your next coat. My next coat's gonna be the yellow. I'm gonna make sure that gets on there. And you can leave this wax on even under your clear coat. It will still flake away. So I'm gonna wait till the very last to get rid of all this. And let's just get to painting the next coat. Okay, we are on day two and my tote is now dry. It's got a nice yellow coat on it. The coat is not perfect. So you can see, kind of see some areas come through here and there. Because this is gonna be underneath our top layer, this is the part that's gonna show through the crackle, and then we're gonna do a little extra distressing on this. So it didn't have to be perfect, but now we're ready to get down to the next layer of paint. And before I do that, we have one step to take. First, we're gonna need to grab some good old Elmer's glue. I know, big fancy craft supplies here, Elmer's school glue. And it doesn't actually have to be Elmer's school glue. You can use Mod Podge. Mod Podge is significantly more expensive, so I'm not using mine. But if you don't have any Elmer's glue and you do have Mod Podge on hand, works the same way. Dollar Tree has glue. Dollar General, Target, whoever glue you have. Glue or Mod Podge. I'm sure you can go on Pinterest and find a bunch more glues or adhesives that work the same way. So let's get down to business. So what I did was I just took a chip brush and I put it in the glue and I brushed it on thicker in some areas than in other areas, because what'll happen is when you put the next layer of paint on, where the glue is heaviest, the cracks will be wider, and where it's lighter, it's going to be finer cracks. So what I did was, because how a piece would normally crack would be from the outside into the middle, I did a heavy coat of glue on both edges. At least that's how I want my cracking to go on. And then I dragged my brush lightly towards the center like this. And as you can see, I'm getting finer glue marks here. So tilt that and you can kind of see. I did that up here as well. I did heavy marks on the handle because if you're thinking about how something would naturally age or crack, the damage is gonna be more severe where there's more wear. So where you would actually carry the piece or hit the edges, you're gonna see more distressing. So I have seen people who have gone a little overboard with the crackle finish and they'll cover a whole piece and it just doesn't look natural. And I think that's where a lot of people have been turned off by crackling. But with the different techniques that I'm going to employ on this piece, hopefully you'll have more of a natural distressed layered paint look. So right now the glue is fresh. I'm going to wait till it gets slightly tacky, not completely dry, just a little tacky. And then we'll put the next coat of paint over the top. Okay, it is starting to dry in some places almost completely, so I want to make sure I get this on before it gets too dry. And what I've got here is Junk Gypsy's Wanderlust is the color. It's that pretty turquoise of theirs. So I'm going to use this as my next coat. Now, the part that trips a lot of people up is your brush is going to stick on the glue and you're going to want to like brush it back and forth and get it all finish coated. Don't do that. This is like, you got to kind of just let it be, let it happen. And it goes against like your entire instinct to do. I mean, you want to, it's just frustrating. As a painter, you're going to want to cover it, but you're going to do another coat on there. So don't freak out. Okay, I have just finished painting the bottom of the tote because bottom is important too. And while we're waiting for that to dry, I'm going to take my knife. I have a letter opener, an old letter opener that I found at a thrift store. And we are going to start scraping off the wax. So all you need to do is take an edge, and we know that we put wax up here. Put a little pressure on it, and that wax is going to come all the way down. So you can see the red coming through. All right, let me get you close. And so you can see where the wax came off. It is going right down to the red without doing any damage. I'm barely putting any pressure on that at all. And I'm just taking the edge and scraping away the wax. And then the paint will come right up down to that layer of red. And I'm going to continue doing that until I get all the places that we hit with wax. Okay, I have now taken off quite a bit of paint, as you can see. Got the crackle finish, and because I swirled my paint, I got a different sort of crackle texture than probably what you're used to, but I think it looks more natural this way. The next distress technique that we're going to do to bring out the layers is we're going to sand it a little bit. Now that just gives it more of a worn look. And just remember, with any of these paint techniques, if you don't like it, it's just paint. So if you start to take away layers and you're like, oh, I wish I hadn't done that, put it back on. You can always put it back on. So there was a section here that I didn't care for the scraping that I had done, so I repainted over the top. And I want that to be more of a worn area. So we're gonna take our sandpaper and we're just going to give it a light, you heard me say light, right? A light sanding. Because what you're gonna do is, as you start to sand, you'll see the layers of paint come up, and I've already started to see here, and I'm gonna turn the camera around so you can see it, but I'm barely putting any effort, any weight on it, and the paint's coming away. So you'll start to see like the paint will sort of fade back, and that's a different look from any of the other textures so far that we've put on there. So we've had the crackles and the actual flaking, chipping, gouging kind of look, and now this is going to be a fade back. And then we're going to do one more technique that you can only do with chalk paint, and that's the water distress. Okay, so I'm going to start sanding here on this area in here, and you'll start seeing the edges of where the gouge was start to smooth away. So right now you get that flake, that definite chippy peely look, and in some areas where we want it to look more like it's been handled more, the chippy peely will start to fade back, and you'll see layers of color come off the red. You'll see a little yellow and then fade back into the blue. So we're gonna just lightly sand this. So there's the yellow coming up.
and then it fades back into the blue. Now, once we're done, we're going to clear coat the whole thing, so hopefully all these colors will start to blend in and some of the flakiness is going away here. And you do not have to be this fussy on any of your pieces if you don't want to. You can certainly just leave it where it is if you like it, or with mine, I want to kind of give it that more detailed, distressed look. Yeah, I like that. And the last bit of distressing that I'm going to do is actually a water distressing, and I'm going to take back the paint just a little bit more. So I'm getting what I want in very fine steps. So it takes a while to do it the way I like to see the distressing. This is optional for you. Now, water distressing can only be done with a chalk or clay type paint. And all you do is you need a piece of cloth and some water. Now, I like a terry cloth because it has a little grit, a little texture to it, sort of like sandpaper does. You don't need that. I've also used my daughter's old socks from when she was a baby, but I will take this with a little water. And I wanna get this piece here. There we go. Now I'm getting what I want. Okay, so you can see the paint really fades into the turquoise, and that the yellow fades into the turquoise, or the turquoise fades into the yellow. I don't know. You guys decide on how you think the direction is going, but it gives it more of that natural wear. So as you see, I pull it off and it slides sort of down, fades into. That looks like you've handled it a million times, and that's when the pieces start coming together to me. Do you remember how I said it's just paint? I don't like this. I hate this big spot. I don't want a big spot, so I'm gonna take a little more of my wanderlust. I'm gonna shake it up, I'm gonna get a brush, and we're gonna fix it. Okay, I guess I'm showing you a fifth technique, technically, for layering paint, because I'm gonna show you dry brushing. Now, dry brushing, for those of you who don't know, is where you take your brush, and you're just gonna dab a bit of paint on it. Now, I have my paint palette here because I like to make sure that I really have very little paint on there, so I'm gonna dab it off. You can do this with a piece of cardboard. You don't actually need a paint palette. And then I'm gonna take a dry brush so it's barely got any paint on it, and I'm gonna drag it across. That's definitely not enough. I'm just gonna, for this, feather in the paint. But dry brushing is a fun way to use up little bits of paint that you have left over and cover things like a gold frame. And I actually have a tutorial on that. You wanna see it. There you are, and then hopefully once it's dry, you won't even notice where I filled in that section. So, I mean, you'll know where it is, and I'll know where it is, but hopefully nobody else will. I think I'm gonna add one more layer of color. I think I'm gonna add a metallic copper glaze over the top because it looks very new right now, and I really want it to have sort of an aged feel. The copper will do that. I have a hate-hate relationship with glazes. I think they make something I just spent hours working on look very dirty. But with this flower, I'm envisioning it as a flower basket. I think that's kind of what I want, is that it looks kind of dirty. So this is paint. It's just paint. We can do this. I can do this.
I usually have to repaint the whole thing when I do this. You know what? We're going to do it. We're going to do it anyway. All right. We're going to take Wise Owl metallic copper glaze. I'm going to go over the top. Well, I don't love it. That usually means it'll sell right away in the shop. It's just the nature of the beast. If I don't like it, somebody else is going to love it and want to take it home right away. I mean, there is a lid for every pot. Let me show you what it looked like. I liked the brighter colors and the way the glaze toned down the yellow and the turquoise. I thought that's what I wanted. I would have liked it brighter. So it's just personal preference. But whether you like it or whether you hate it, you now know 5 different techniques to layering different paints to give yourself a distressed look. So thanks for watching, everyone.
Visit my blog, peonylanedesigns.com, for more tips, tricks, and inspiration. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll be notified of new videos. I post every week DIY tutorials and, of course, more Junkin videos.